Okay, today we're going to talk about three or four or five, maybe six things about the new Hero 9 Black that I do not like. I've been using GoPro for a long time. I jumped on the Hero 9 for some things that I do really like. I love the front-facing screen. I love the bigger battery, and the corresponding longer battery life unless you're shooting at 5K. So I like those things, but here are some things that I don't like. The first thing that I don't like, I love the front-facing touchscreen. I do not like that you can't reactivate the touchscreen on the front by touching it. That seems like it's a no-brainer, but when the front screen goes out, you actually have to reach around and touch the back of the camera. And if the camera's not running, you risk changing the mode that the camera is in at that time. So that's a little bit of a bummer. I do want the front screen to turn off, but it'd be nice if I could turn it back on by using voice control. I need to check and make sure that's not a feature. Now that I think about it, voice control for the front screen would be really nice. So that's the first thing I don't like. I love the front screen. I hate that I can't turn it back on by touching it. I've got to reach around the camera. So another problem that I have isn't really the Hero 9. It's a little bit the Hero 9. It's that the GoPro app still sucks. They've worked really hard to build a system that makes it easy for non-filmmakers to edit their material. And that app is still hard to use. I use it mainly on my iPad, and sometimes it'll be able to do landscape. Sometimes it won't do landscape. Sometimes you gotta trick it to do landscape. The buttons don't always make sense for what they do. But really the problem for me as not as a newbie user is I need something just to help me manage files. And so, for instance, if I want to use the GoPro app to wirelessly pull files off of the Hero 9, I can do that, but I have to save it to the GoPro app and then save it again or move it again to someplace else on my iPad, as opposed to the GoPro app having a button, download this file, where do you want to put it? Right? Those are my options. So that's just not great. I also don't like the lag when previewing video. I like to use it as a monitor while I'm shooting, and there's a disconcerting lag. I really wish it was a little bit more live. So not really the Hero 9, but you do need to have the app running to set up your Hero 9. So you kind of can't go without it the way you used to be able to. So that's something I'm not real happy about. This would only drive you crazy if you've used a lot of GoPros. It takes a long time for this camera to start up and to shut down. And I don't mean start recording once it's powered up. I mean to power up and then to power down when you're done takes significantly longer than on the Hero 8. It's got nice graphics and all that, so you're distracted, but it's definitely slower. So when you're in a hurry, it kind of makes your skin crawl. Another thing that I'm not thrilled with is the touchscreen on the back. I've already mentioned that the camera itself takes longer to start up and slow and shut down. But also the touchscreen isn't as responsive as it used to be. Maybe it's stuff on my fingers from salt water and stuff like that, but I have a hard time, or I'm having a hard time getting it to be responsive. If you hold it too long, it goes into a settings mode on the touchscreen. But if you don't tap it long enough, it doesn't do anything, and you sort of need that hello. You sort of need that to find that in between place. So I find frequently to touch, particularly if I'm changing the lens size, which I do frequently, I've got to do it multiple times, and I generally end up someplace where I don't want to be. And I've also noticed the problem when scrolling, like on the general settings screen, you go to scroll, but you inadvertently activate something. So then you have to back out of it, scroll again. So not thrilled with that. I suspect that that's a firmware issue. I've already had to update the firmware once. Oh, you know, there was the audio popping problem, which I didn't even mention. So I think I've got that fixed, but I'm not really sure. I won't know until I look at the footage from this week. The last thing about the Hero 9 that I don't like is that they bumped the price by $50. I mean, I don't know anything about what it costs to manufacture a camera like that, but it was really nice that every year I could upgrade for the same price as my original buy-in. Was super nice. And I mean, that bugs me a little bit. And I'm not even paying full price, and it still bugs me. But yeah, a little bummed that they raised the price on it. You know, and it forces me to buy all new batteries because it's a bigger battery, which I'm thrilled with the bigger battery, but now I gotta get a new dual battery charger and things like that. They're gonna get their money out of me one way or the other. In general, I love their cameras. They work really well for me. I've been using them a long time. But that hurt me a little bit that it's an additional $50. Okay, so that's what I dislike about the Hero 9 Black. Really, for the most part, I like everything, but those are the things that are problematic for me. All right, I'll see you outside.